24 hours out from the corruption watchdog releasing a report into her conduct. Former Premier Gladys Berejiklian has given a keynote address on leadership in Western Sydney. Lachlan Kennedy joins me now live from State Parliament. Lachlan, what was the speech about?
Sandra, it was an hour and a half speech and question and answer session titled Leadership, Reflections and Lessons Learned. She gave it to an event organised by the Western Sydney Leadership Dialogue. She gave it over Zoom, a commitment she made months ago, but one she kept even though this final report from ICAC is looming large. This report from the anti-corruption watchdog into whether her secret relationship with DarylMaguire did constitute a breach of public trust will be hand-delivered here at State Parliament behind me at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. How long it's taken to reach this point does remain a very hot topic here on Macquarie Street, and tonight I can confirm the government will be amending, changing the Act of Parliament that governs ICAC to make sure that it sets time standards, benchmarks for how long its reports take in the future. It's the delay casting a dark cloud over Macquarie Street.
Are you willing to sit down with the opposition and crossbench on how to ensure that in the future ICAC investigates and reports in a timely manner?
I'm prepared to work with all parties, minor parties, independents on any issue affecting this parliament. I think that's important. In relation to that report, it's released tomorrow and we await those findings.
Public hearings in Operation Keppel began in September 2020, initially investigating former Wagga MP DarylMaguire before expanding a year later to include former Premier Gladys Berejiklian. After multiple extensions, ICAC will deliver its report tomorrow.
It's too long. It's not good enough.
But the corruption watchdog will soon be on the clock. The government has agreed to change the ICAC Act, setting guidelines for how long a report should take, stating that requiring the agency to develop its own time standards and measure its performance against them will increase transparency and public accountability. The opposition wants Parliament involved in setting those new timeframes.
Really, a report should be produced within 6 months of the conclusion of public hearings.
It's not the only report under scrutiny. A snapshot of the public service has revealed a jump in well-paid fat cats. 2 years ago, there were 3,600 senior executives. Over the course of 12 months, the former coalition government hired 379 more, each on an average salary of $262,000.
This explosive growth is going to cost New South Wales taxpayers at least $400 million over the next 4 years.
The coalition says it had planned to cut 20% of executives. Lachlan Kennedy for 10 News First.